We know very little about the deep sea, especially compared to other spots on Earth or even space.
Marine biologist Eddie Kisfaldi wanted to learn more about what happens when an animal dies in the ocean. What happens to the remains?
This particular animal washed up on the beach. We found it in great condition. And so we thought that putting it on the deep sea floor, turning on the cameras over time, would help us better tell this story about what happens to all these animals once they die and start decomposing. What is that story?
And I think we chose a really nice place for this dolphin.
Decomposition, the breaking down of organic tissue, starts to happen when any organism, plant or animal, dies. It's a natural process, and it's part of the food web that cycles matter and nutrients through an ecosystem, whether on land or in the deep sea. Because the presence of scuba divers and their equipment can scare creatures that would make use of a large carcass, divers had to position the cameras and leave, making this the first time the decomposition of a deep sea marine mammal has been filmed in time lapse.
All animals in the ocean eventually have to expire, and if they're far away from land, they eventually sink down to the sea floor. Because it's difficult to stumble upon a whale or a dolphin on the sea floor to understand that community, we have to put these down in a place that we know about to watch the animals and try to better understand what this ecosystem is really doing in the deep sea. We do know that the deep sea is a very dark, cold, lonely place that doesn't get many visitors. So when a dolphin shows up from the surface, it's a very exciting time for a deep sea animal because you now have a place to stay, perhaps. You've got lots of food. If you're a small worm or a crab, this might be the place to where you're going to start to reproduce.
Over time, the carcass becomes a living, thriving ecosystem, hosting an array of life, including single-cell bacteria, crustaceans, and sharks.
It turned out that animals of all different phyla came and visited this carcass. There were small fish, there were crabs, octopus. One fish made a home out of the bones, while other fish just used it for protection.
When an animal dies, it provides vital energy and nutrients to other organisms in that ecosystem. This cycle of transferring energy and nutrients from one organism to another is called a food chain. Creatures that eat dead animals are called scavengers. An example of a land-based scavenger is the vulture. When an organism dies, scavengers will feed off the carcass. This transfers nutrients and energy to the scavenger. Meanwhile, the natural process of decomposition breaks down all the matter and nutrients in the deceased animal, returning them to the environment. When an animal dies on land, it's easier to witness the process of decomposition. But in the deep ocean, it requires technology, a lot of equipment, and dedication.
This was no easy task. We had lots of technological challenges. You're dealing with huge amounts of equipment. As hard as all of this was, we were successful because we now know a little bit more about what happens after a dolphin dies in the ocean.